What's up, guys? Davis here, back in the old MMO news booth thingy that I shoot in. It's been a while. We had the Christmas break and tour launch and stuff, but I'm going to be back in my Monday-Thursday schedule, except for next Thursday. I'll be in Vegas at CES, which will be fun, but I won't be able to do news. Maybe I'll vlog. Who knows? Anyways, let's get to the news. Some new footage of Planetside 2 has sprung up on the game's website, showing off a mixture of ground and vehicular combat. Let's take a look.
Planetside 2 showcases the largest scale combat ever seen in an online shooter. Thousands of players can directly and simultaneously compete with one another in enormous battles featuring air and ground vehicles, as well as intense first-person infantry action. We have a phenomenal next-gen engine built from the ground up to provide some of the most incredible visual effects imaginable and enable the enormous scale of battles found in Planetside 2.
Using a brand new Forge Light engine, we're able to take our characters, vehicles, and weapons to the next level. Following the original design cues from Planetside 1, we've visually enhanced each of the factions while keeping the look and feel players are used to. The Terran Republic has more smooth lines and circles. The NC, the new conglomerate, is more about squares, hard edges, 45-degree angles, and 90-degree angles. The Vinyl Sovereignty, my favorite faction, is more about triangles, curves, and shapes that are more scalloped and layered, and more ornate. As you can see, we've added a higher level of detail on each of the three factions while staying true to their history.
Oh, this game looks awesome. I played the original Planetside and I love the concept. I think it was just a bit too early or too ahead of its time, but this one looks great. It's mixing my two favorite genres, FPSs and MMOs, into one sexual package that I just cannot wait to play. Sony Online Entertainment has announced that a new form of crafting will be making its way to DC Universe Online in the near future. It's called Research and Development, and it involves collecting these tiny objects called exobits that are scattered around the game's world and using them to create powerful mods with consumables. What is it about crafting that is just so much fun? It's not even all that involved or cool. You know, you just get things and you click and stuff, but and every MMO I played, I always loved crafting. I don't know, it feels like I'm accomplishing something even though I'm not. You know, I can do things in games that I could never do in the real world, like leather working. Although I do enjoy leather. And latex. In Final Fantasy XIV, new Square has announced they're going to finally start charging players a subscription fee again starting tomorrow, January 6th. Now, as a token of appreciation to their valued customers, they'll be offering a discounted rate of $10 a month until version 2.0 of the game drops. Who is running this company? It was a step in the right direction to not charge a subscription fee while your game is broken, but don't start charging again until the actual fixes come out, and don't be like, oh, but no, it's cool, we're gonna charge you less than we normally would. That's some bullshit. Also, Tor just came out, so you have this huge MMO to compete with, and really, when it comes out, you're gonna like start charging money. That's gonna even further de-incentivize people to play your goddamn game. I think I'm just gonna stop reading all Final Fantasy XIV news because it just makes me upset. And like, it's not good for my stress levels. They're already pretty high, you know. And in Davis news, man, it's a new year. Whole 365 days of new possibilities to seize. If you guys haven't checked it out already, on the Warp Zone, we dropped a new drinking game for gamers called League of Loggers. It's really fun, and I'm really glad we got to do something like Legends related because I love the game. In Tor, the Warp Zone Guild is doing great. We already got some 50s. I'll be hitting level 50 pretty soon, although CES is probably gonna get in the way of my leveling. But if you guys are looking for a public server, we're on the Warriors of the Shadow server. Just hit up my character's name is Ribs or Schroeder's Exen or just anyone in the guild. They'll invite you. We'll have a good time. We're gonna start raiding pretty soon. We'd love to PvP and just joke around. So please join if you want to. It's awesome. And that's it for today's show, guys. It's good to be back. We should do this again sometime. How's Monday? Does that work for you? Works for me. Awesome. If you want to follow me on Twitter, you can do so at Team Davis or Warps on Tweets. I'm Davis, and I'll see you the f*** later.